Hi there, welcome back. Let's talk about data validation. So for this video, you will learn about data integrity as well as different methods of data validation. So first of all, data validation and data verification help protect the integrity of data by checking whether the data entered is accurate, consistent, and up to date. And integrity of data can be compromised during the data entry and data transmission stages, as well as by malicious attacks on the data, for example, malware and hacking, or by accidental data loss caused by hardware issues. So for this video itself, we look at different methods of data validation to actually protect integrity of data. So first of all, data validation is used to check if data is valid. It means that we are checking whether the data is reasonable or sensible. But the problem with data validation is it cannot check if data is correct or accurate. So for example, if someone types their age as 119 instead of 19, is a reasonable or valid value, but it's not accurate or correct. So this is the key point that you always have to remember about data validation. Basically, for data validation, we can only check whether the data is valid, but we cannot 100% guarantee that the data is always correct or accurate. And now let's look at different types of data validation. So the first one will be range check. Basically, for range check, you are just checking the input data must be between a set of values. So for example, program offers 4 choices, 1, 2, 3, 4 to proceed. Input number must be between 1 to 4. Any other input will be invalid and rejected. So this is the typical example of range check. And next will be format check. It means that data must follow certain format or correct pattern or order. The example is product codes must start with 2 uppercase letters followed by 2 digit characters. So for example, AB99 is valid. So 2 uppercase character AB and then 99, 2 digit characters. But ABB4 and A666 are invalid. Next, we have length check, which means length of data such as number of characters is fixed. So for example, all phone numbers should contain 11 digits. And then we have presence check. Basically, it means that a field must contain a value. It cannot be left blank. So for example, in SQL database, syntax not now means data cannot be left blank, such as customer's name cannot be empty. And then we also have assistant check. Basically, it checks if data in a file or a file name actually exists. So for assistant check, most of the time you're just checking whether this value exists, that value exists, and etc. So for example, we can validate if a file name or an email address does exist using assistant check. Furthermore, we have limit check, which checks only one of the limits, such as upper limit or lower limit. So for example, we can check number of matches for football per season cannot exceed 38. And the last method will be check digit. So basically, a digit, usually the rightmost position, is used as an answer to an arithmetic operation of other digits in data. If not matched, then data enter incorrectly. So if you look at the definition, you might not understand what it means, but no worries. We will go through a practical example later. And check digit is always used in barcodes, ISBNs, which are found on the cover of a book, to check errors such as incorrect digit being entered, digits being omitted or added, and etc. And now let's look at one example of check digit calculation. So first of all, check digit calculation use modular 11 with this algorithm for a number with 7 digits. It means that for this example, we have like 7 digits and we are trying to compute a single check digit based on these 7 digits. So first of all, each digit in the number is given a weighting of 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 starting from the left. And then the digit is multiplied by its weighting and then each value is added to make a total. And next would be the total is divided by 11 and the remainder subtracted from 11. And the last step is the check digit is the value generated. If the check digit is 10, then X is used. So if you look at all these sentences, they might still not make sense, but no worries. Let's go through a practical example together. So first of all, we have this random 7-digit number here. So 4, 1, 5, 6, 7, 1, 0. And then we have this empty space here. So this empty space is actually for the check digit later. And the next row will be weighting. So remember that in the previous slide, we talked about weighting from 7 all the way to 1. And the next thing that we will do is, we will just multiply each digit with the weighting. So for example, 4 times 7, and then 1 times 6, and etc. So the next row will be the total sum. So if you look at this, this is the total sum. So 28, 6, 25, 24, 21, 2, 0. And then we will sum all the numbers together to get one single number. So when you sum all the numbers together, you will actually get this 106 here. And the next step is divide total by 11. So if you divide 106 with 11, you will get 9 with remainder 7. And the last step is subtract remainder from 11. So the remainder was 7. So 11 minus 7, we get 4. So 4 is actually the check digit based on this 7 digit number. Therefore, the final number will be this number here. So the first 7 digit numbers remain the same. We just add 4 as the check digit as the last digit for this number. Therefore, this is how we can compute the check digit based on this 7 digit number. And before we end, let's look at one partial question. State the type of validation check that each of the algorithm performs. So the first one will be input X. If X is less than 0 or X is more than 10, then output invalid N. So what is the validation check for this question A? So this is the one mark question. And then the next question is input X. If X is equal to empty, then output invalid. And if so, this is also a one mark question. And the last question is input X. If not X is equal to red, or X is equal to yellow, or X is equal to blue, then output invalid and if. So these are the questions for validation check. Definitely just refer back to the video and comment your answer down below. Thank you, and I will see you again then. Bye bye.